Your life is a bit like a Jeffrey Archer story, isn't it? Yes. It's full of twists and turns, full of red herrings. The plot changes when you least expect it.
Yes, I'm afraid it is. But that hasn't been a bad thing in the sense that if you're going to be a writer, if you're going to give people stories, it's not a bad thing to have had some experiences yourself.
But how did the journey really begin?
Well, I didn't intend to be a writer. That is not what I wanted to be. I wanted to be a politician. And after my days at Oxford, I wanted to enter the House of Commons. And I first went on the Greater London Council when I was 26, and then I entered the House at the age of 29. And I left the House of Commons 5 years later in 1974 because I was facing bankruptcy. So I had to get a job. And I thought the idea of a man losing his money and discovering that it had been stolen by someone and calling three other people together and telling them, we're going to steal it back. Not a penny more, not a penny less. Very simple story. The shock was that millions of people bought it. That was the shock. And I suddenly had a second career that had never been intended.
Would you want to win the Booker?
I can't. I'm not capable of it. There are several reasons I'm not capable of it. Not least, the Booker Prize is not given for storytelling. They're won by amazing writers.
Sure.
But they don't go around claiming to be storytellers. And I don't go around claiming to be a writer.
Is there a theme or a tale that you haven't told and you want to tell?
Oh, many. Sit patiently, child. They are still to come. You will interview me in 30 years' time. And you will ask the same question.